In this video, I'm going to show you 10 really useful Photoshop keyboard shortcuts that you don't know, probably. Hi everyone, welcome back to another very exciting tutorial here at the PhotoshopTrainingChannel.com. My name is Jesus Ramirez and you can find me on Instagram at JRFromPTC. In this Photoshop tutorial, I'm going to show you 10 really useful keyboard shortcuts that you probably don't know. If this is your first time at the Photoshop Training Channel, then remember to subscribe and enable the notification bell. Also, as you're watching this video, let me know in the comments how many of these shortcuts were new to you, and also let me know what shortcuts I missed that you find really useful. That way, the comments section can be a good resource for great keyboard shortcuts. Okay, let's get started. The first shortcut is how to redo the last selection. Photoshop actually remembers the last selection that you use. Let me show you how that works. I'm going to select the quick selection tool and I'm going to make a selection around her arms. And I'm going to hold Alt, Option, and the Mac to subtract from the selection. And now that I have her arm selected, I can create a new layer. And I'm just going to paint in a shadow. So I'm going to paint with black. Like so. Then I can press Control D, Command D to deselect. And I can continue painting a shadow down here. And maybe now I want to add to the shadow or maybe create highlights on her sleeves. But I don't want to waste the time creating the selection again. So I can simply press Control Shift D. That's Command Shift D in the Mac to bring back the last active selection. So now I can paint with white on a new layer with the overlay blending mode. And now I can create highlights on her sweater. Then I can press Control D, Command D to deselect. And if I need to bring back the selection, once again, Control Shift D, Command Shift D on the Mac. The next keyboard shortcut that I'm going to show you is the Lock Transparent Pixels shortcut. So I'm going to select the brush tool, and then I'm going to select the color that you can really see. So I'm going to select red, and I'm going to create a new layer, and I'm going to paint with red. So maybe you're painting or retouching or doing anything where you're creating new pixels on a blank layer. Then, if I want to make an adjustment, like maybe paint with a different color, so I'll select blue, and you want to paint directly over those pixels, but not affect the pixels that are transparent, then you're going to need to use this keyboard shortcut. I'm going to undo that by pressing Ctrl+Alt+C. What you want to do is press the question mark key, which is the / key, and then that locks transparent pixels. So when you paint, you only paint on the pixels that are opaque, not they're transparent. Also notice in the layers panel that the lock transparent pixels icon is selected and there is a lock on that layer. So I can press the / key to remove that and now I can paint anywhere in the layer. I can press the / key again and maybe use a different tool, like maybe the burn tool. And I can burn only the opaque pixels. I'm not generating any new ones by painting on transparent pixels. The next keyboard shortcut that I'm going to talk about is one that actually gave me a lot of problems when I was first starting out in Photoshop. I have the brush tool selected and you can see the brush preview. If I use the bracket keys on the keyboard to increase or decrease the size of my brush, you'll see the cursor change. It's giving us a preview of the actual brush. But if you inadvertently hit the caps lock key, we no longer get that preview. We just have the crosshair cursor on our painting tool. So even if you decrease or increase the size of the brush, which I'm doing now, you won't see the preview. So make sure that the caps lock key is off if you're ever missing that preview of the brush. And the very first time that I came up across this problem, I actually ended up uninstalling Photoshop, believe it or not, because I thought my Photoshop was broken. That was back with Photoshop version 7. And I'm sure I'm not the only one who was confused by the caps lock key. If it's confused you as well, let me know in the comments below. But anyway, just remember, the cap lock key gives you the crosshair cursor or the brush preview, and I prefer the brush preview, of course. The next keyboard shortcut I want to show you is the fit to screen or bird's eye view keyboard shortcut, which is really the same one. So I'm going to press Control T, Command T to transform, and I'm going to zoom out. Then I'm going to make this image larger, like so. Then I'm going to double tap on the hand tool, which fits the image to screen. And actually, the keyboard shortcut to fit to screen is Control 0. However, when you press Control T, Command T on the Mac to transform, but the corner handles are outside the canvas and you cannot see them, you can use that same keyboard shortcut, Control 0, to zoom out and see the handles. So whenever you transform something and you don't see the handles, Control 0, Command 0. Also, as a side note, Control 1, Command 1 on the Mac, zooms in to 100%, the actual view. So basically the same thing as double-clicking in the hand tool or right-clicking with the zoom tool and selecting 100%. In the next keyboard shortcut, I'm going to show you how to toggle the canvas color. So I'm going to zoom out just so that we can see. Sometimes you're working with an image and your canvas color really doesn't help you see the image. So you may need to change the color of it so that you can see the image better. So you can press the space bar and the F key on the keyboard to toggle between the canvas colors. See that? See how I'm toggling between the canvas colors? And you can add your own custom canvas color if you like. But I prefer the presets that Photoshop has available. So once again, spacebar and the F key. If you want to toggle the canvas colors to the opposite direction, just add the shift key to that. The next keyboard shortcut that I'm going to show you is the feather selection keyboard shortcut. So I'm going to select the elliptical marquee tool, and I'm going to create a very simple selection like so. Notice that the feather is set to zero, which means that if I create a new layer and fill, say, with the foreground color, and you can do so by holding Alt and Backspace, you will of course get a really sharp edge. But if you want to feather that, then what you would need to do is deselect, type in the feather amount that you want, and then make the selection again. But if you created a complicated selection, it might take you too long to redo the selection. So what you want to do is apply the feather to the selection. To do so, you can hold Shift and the F6 key. One of the function keys, Shift and F6, and that brings up the feather selection window, and you can enter a feather radius. We can try 20 pixels and press OK. Now, if we fill with the foreground color, Alt and Backspace, Option Delete on the Mac, you'll see now that we no longer have a sharp fill. We now have a fill with feather. In the next example, I'm going to show you how to use the spring-loaded keyboard shortcut. So this is not really a single keyboard shortcut. It's more of how the keyboard shortcuts affect the tools if you use them a certain way. So let's say we have the burn tool selected and I start burning the image and I want to zoom in. I can hold Z and I'm still holding Z, zoom in, release, and it goes back into the burn tool. So I didn't really have to select it again. So whenever you hold a keyboard shortcut down, the tool will temporarily be selected. And when you release, you'll go back to the previous tool. So maybe in this case, you can hold the R key to rotate, click and drag. We rotate the image. I release the R key and I go back into the burn tool. I'm going to rotate again. Now there's a trick to that. However, if you hold R and you click and drag to rotate, make sure that you release the mouse button first and then the R key. Because if you hold the letter R, click to rotate and release the letter R first, it'll go into the actual rotate tool. See that, how that now is selected? So make sure that you release the mouse button first and then release the letter R. I'm going to double click on the rotate tool to bring it back to the regular view. And I'm just going to select the hand tool and double click on that to fit the image to screen. In the next example, I'm going to show you something that I have here on this folder. I have two circles, a black circle and a white circle. If you wanted to create a design where you're going to fill something around the circle, maybe you're creating a watch or something like that, there's a keyboard shortcut that you should know, which is the repeat the last transformation keyboard shortcut. So I'm going to press Control H, Command H, to bring back guides that I was hiding, Control H, Command H, hide CXRES. And I'm going to press Control T, Command T to transform, click and drag the pivot point to the center of that circle. Then I can change the rotation to 20 degrees and hit enter. So that, of course, rotates that circle into that position. Now, if I press Control Alt Shift T, Command Option Shift T to duplicate that same transformation onto a new layer, watch what happens. I'm pressing that same keyboard shortcut over and over and over again. So that duplicates that circle around the larger circle. And that works because we change the pivot point to the center of the larger circle. And we change in increments of 20 degrees, which of course divides equally among the 360 degrees of a circle. So you can use this technique to create very interesting designs by simply duplicating the last transformation that you did onto a new layer. And the next keyboard shortcut that I want to show you is one that I use all the time. And I like to call it the whoopsie daisy key, because when you make a mistake, you can always go back and not even worry about pressing cancel or anything like that. Let me show you what I mean by that. So maybe you're working in Photoshop and you click on the crop tool and you decide that you no longer want to be in the crop tool. Maybe even you started making a crop, but you really want to cancel that. Simply press the escape key and that'll get rid of that. Maybe you open up a window. So let me switch tools and go into edit, fill, and decide that you no longer want the fill window. You can just press the escape key. The same thing will happen with any window. Maybe you press Control K, Command K on the Mac to bring up the preferences panel. Maybe you don't want it anymore. You can press the escape key. If you select the type tool and you click and you decide that you no longer want that text layer, you can simply press the escape key and that cancels out of that tool and the layer disappears. So if you make a mistake and you're in a tool or window that you don't want to be in, just hit the escape key. Now, the next few examples are extras. These are just a couple things that I use all the time. So one of those is with text. So I'm going to create a text box. Then I'm going to go into type, paste lorem ipsum, which is the generic text. And I'm just going to press Control A, Command A to select all the text. And I'm going to change the color to white so that you can see it better. So notice how there's hyphens. That is hyphenation, and that's enabled by default. So if you want to get rid of the hyphens, just press Control A, Command A on the Mac to select all the text. And then you can press Control Alt Shift H. That's Command Option Shift H on the Mac. And it gets rid of all the hyphens. It removes the hyphenation. And the way of doing that without a keyboard shortcut is by going into the paragraph panel, clicking on the flyout menu, selecting hyphenation, and then unchecking this checkbox. So the keyboard shortcut is so much easier. Once again, the keyboard shortcut is Control Alt Shift H, Command Option Shift H on the Mac. Another keyboard shortcut that I use all the time is holding the Alt key on any one of these eye icons to hide all the other layers except for the layer that I clicked on. So I held Alt Option on the Mac, click on this layer, and all the other layers were hidden. I can do the same thing again to bring them back. I can do the same thing with this black circle. So hold Alt Option on the Mac, click on the eye icon to hide all other visible layers, and to bring them back, Alt Option on the Mac and click again. And the last bonus keyboard shortcut is another one that I use a lot when I make mistakes. Sometimes you just make too many mistakes on one file that you have to go back to the last time that you saved it or to how the file first looked when it was open. You can simply press the F12 key on the keyboard, function 12, to revert the image. So how many of these shortcuts were new to you? Let me know in the comments below. And as I said earlier in the video, post your favorite keyboard shortcut not shown in this video in the comments and check out what other people are commenting, and maybe you'll discover something that can be useful to you. Don't forget to click on that subscribe and notification buttons. I really hope that you enjoy this tutorial and that you learned something new. Thank you so much for watching, and I will talk to you again soon.